In this video, we're going to work through the Finance in Excel Part 1 that is found in your lab book. So the purpose of this part in Excel is to show you how to use the FV function. And the FV function is the future value function, and we can use it to figure out the future value of some type of savings account. And your book has formulas that you can use. They're in the PowerPoint, and they're also shown on your lab book in the first paragraph or so. And you're welcome to use the formulas. If you figure out how to use them and you like using them, you're welcome to do so. But I think most students find that the FV function, once they figure it out, is actually easier and quicker, and you're less likely to make calculation errors. And I found that students that use this FV function do better on the last test and the final exam than students that try to do it by hand using the formula, but it's your choice. So in this formula, we have a bunch of different variables, and the first thing is P, which is the principal. It's how much money goes into the account. And then APR is the annual percentage rate. That's how much interest the bank is paying you. N represents the number of times per year that you're paid interest. And Y is the number of years that the money's in the account. And so we're going to use all of that information to figure out how much money you'll have at some point in the future. Okay. So again, we're going to see how we do the FV function. And I'm going to create a chart. So in my chart, I'm going to list out my APR. APR, N, Y, PMT, P, and at the bottom, FV, future value. And on the test, we're going to give you the formula that you see. It's kind of near the bottom of the first page. It's in bold. It says equals FV, parentheses, APR divided by N, comma, N times Y, comma, negative PMT, comma, P close parentheses. We're going to give you that formula on the test. We don't expect you to memorize it. That's what we're going to be working with. And the way I set the chart is I'm basically looking inside the parentheses and listing those values in order. So APR came first, and then N, and then Y, then negative PMT, and then P. So I'm just listing those out in order, and then FV is the future value. That's how much money I'm going to have. That's at the bottom because that's what this formula is calculating. So once I kind of get my chart set up, now I type in the formula. So I'm going to do it exactly as it's written. And again, you don't have to memorize this. We're going to give it to you. But I'm going to do equals FV, then open parentheses, then cell reference, the APR cell divided by the N cell, comma, then your N cell times your Y cell, comma, then negative PMT, comma, negative P, close parentheses. And the biggest mistake I see is that students leave off the negative signs. They make a difference with the way Excel thinks. If you leave off the negative signs, you're going to get wrong answers. So again, we're going to give you that formula on the test. You don't have to memorize it. And I created my chart by just putting those inputs in order and then the future values at the bottom. And then I'm using cell references to put all those values into my FV function. And the first time you do this, it's kind of like, whoa. But once you do it a couple times, it's really not that bad. And by final exam time, hopefully you'll find this kind of easy. So let's see how we use this now that we've got it typed in. So it says, Jim deposits $3,000 into the account. He has an APR of 1.5% compounded daily. Determine the balance in 10 years, assuming no additional deposits or withdrawals. So let's fill in what we know. Our APR is 1.45%. N is the number of times per year that he's paid interest. Since he's paid interest daily, there's 365 days in the year. So I'm going to put that N is 365 days. If they're paying him every single day, they'll pay him 365 times. Y is the number of years, so that's 10. PMT represents a monthly payment. And for this first section, we're going to assume that no one's adding any extra money, so that's 0. And then P is the principal, how much money he puts in initially, which is 3,000. And then it's going to calculate how much money he has total. I'm going to turn off. I don't know why Excel is doing some funny formatting. All right, so again, we put in our interest rate. We put in the number of times that interest is compounded, the number of years. We're not adding any extra money, so monthly payments are 0. Principal is the initial money he puts in, and then that's going to tell us how much money Jim's going to have after 10 years. And Excel does all the math for you, and it spits out the answer. That's really nice. You just set up your chart, put in the numbers, and you get your value. So typically what I would do is just drag my formula over and keep using it, but I want to show you how to set it up again just for practice. So again, we have our formula what you're given, and I'm just putting these values in a chart in the order that they show up inside the formula. And then to put it in Excel, I type equals FV, open parentheses, APR divided by N, comma, N times Y, comma, negative PMT, comma, negative P, close parentheses, enter. So now we're set up and we can do it some more. And I'm actually going to go ahead and drag this over a couple spots so I don't retype it, but now you've seen it a couple times. So at the top of the next page, it says Andrea wants to know how much money she will have in 5 years. So right away, 5 years. If she deposits her $500 into an account, so she's depositing $500 into an account that pays an interest rate of 2.2%. So I'm putting that into my APR compounded monthly. Well, there's 12 months in a year, so she's going to get paid interest 12 times. And then we're not adding any extra money to the account. So we can see that at the end of 5 years, Andrea will have $558.08. So that's pretty good. All right, so then kind of at to the right of the Excel box in the middle of the page, it says Andrea changes her mind and decides that instead she wants to know how long the money must remain in the account to have a future value of $1,000. All right, so this one's different. Now she wants $1,000 and she wants to know how long is it going to take. So if you notice the question that says, how long must it remain in there? That means we're trying to figure out why. So we're going to know the future value. We're trying to figure out why. This is going to be a goal seek question. So everything's the same in this account. It's still 2.2% interest. She's still getting paid monthly. She's still putting her $500 in, but she wants to know how long is it going to be until she has $1,000. So what we want to do is goal seek our future value to 1,000 by changing the number of years, since years is the variable, saying how long is it going to take. So we're going to guess and check a whole bunch of different number of years until we get $1,000. So I'm going to start by clicking on that future value equation and then go up to data, what if analysis, goal seek. I need $1,000 by changing the number of years. And so it says in 31.54 years, she will have $1,000. So not the best savings plan ever, but it's money. It's better than nothing. Then at the bottom of the page, it says, similarly, Andrea wants to have a balance of $600 in only 7 years. So 7 years. We want to figure out what is the APR to reach that value in 7 years. So we're assuming that it's still paid monthly. She's still putting $500 in. But this time it's saying, what is the APR required to get that amount of money? So again, this is goal seek. We know the ending amount. We want $600. We want $600 by changing the APR. So I'm going to start my equation, data, what if analysis, goal seek. We want $600 by changing the APR. We want to know what APR must she get to get $600 in 7 years. And we see that is, let me change that to a percent. She needs 2.61% to have $600 in 7 years. So that's not too bad. Okay, so we've got four more questions. Let's just go through these right quick. I'm going to drag my cell over. So I've got four spots to work. So it says Mario deposits, before that, Mario has a money market savings account with an APR of 3.75% compounded monthly. So monthly is 12 times a year. Let's go ahead and type that in. And I think this is the same value for all of them. So I'm going to go ahead and fill in. So I've got all four spots to work in Excel. Okay, so the first one says Mario deposits $1,500 now and doesn't touch the account, so he's not adding anything to it. How much will he have in 3 years? So this one's pretty basic. We can plug everything in, and we can see in 3 years he'll have $1,678.31. Number two says Mario deposits $1,500 now and doesn't touch the account. How many years must he leave the money to have a future value of $2,000? So again, it's asking how many years. We're trying to solve for why. So we need to goal seek our account to $2,000. So So data, what if analysis, goal seek. We want it to be $2,000 by seeing how many years it's going to take. And we see that it's going to take Mario 7.68 years to reach $2,000 if nothing changes. Okay. Number three says, Mario deposits $1,500 now into an account and doesn't touch the account. So it's depositing $1,500, not adding anything to it. What interest rate compounded monthly would he need to reach $2,000 in 5 years? All right, so we're trying to figure out what interest rate we need to get to $2,000 in 5 years. So I changed my years to five, and now we're going to goal seek the equation to 2,000 by changing the interest rate to see what interest rate it would take. So we want $2,000 by changing the interest rate. And we see he would need 5.77% to get $2,000 in 5 years. Okay, last one. Mario deposits $1,500 into an account that paid an annual interest rate of 3.9%. All right, so we have 3.9%. He's depositing $1,500. We're assuming that he's not going to do anything else for all these problems. It says after 6 years, he has a balance of $1,893.32, which is not what we have down here. Okay, it says determine the method of compounding. All right, we're trying to see compounding, so that means we're going to be interested in our N, how many times per year he's paid interest. So we need to see how many times a year he was paid interest to get to that value in your lab book. And we're doing that by changing how many times it's compounded. So I'm going to do data, what if analysis, goal seek. We want our equation to be 1,893.32 by changing the number of times that it is compounded. And we see that it's compounded four times per year. Well, four times a year we say is quarterly. So he would need quarterly compounding to get this amount of money in 6 years.